Unit will not power on. Make sure the power cord is securely plugged into the power adapter. The power adapter shows a small green light when it is working correctly. Check the exact outlet that you are using by plugging in a lamp. Note that sometimes the bottom outlet in a two-outlet wall plate is controlled by a light switch. The mat or vinyl pulls to one side when it goes through the cutter. Proper alignment when placing the mat or vinyl in the cutter is most important. Also, make sure that the pinch rollers are directly under the black arrows. Make sure that the grit rollers on the bottom bar are clean of any sticky residue. Place your mat or vinyl so that the pinch rollers are near the outside edges. Note that the pinch rollers must always match up with the grit rollers below. You may have better results by adding or removing a middle pinch roller. Make sure the small levers on the back of the pinch rollers are all down, or all up if you happen to be cutting something that needs more pressure. You might be using too much downforce on the blade. Increase the number of passes instead. The blade does not cut all the way through the material. Some materials need multiple passes to cut all the way through. This value is set in your computer software program. Check that the blade offset and overcut settings are correctly in your computer software program. Try increasing pressure before considering extended exposed blade length. The cutter stops or stalls when cutting very thick materials. Try decreasing speed or force and increasing the number of passes. Place the blade holder in the jaw slightly higher to allow the blade to drop further. I cannot get Wi-Fi to connect. First, make sure that the home screen does not say High Link. Make sure that the home screen shows the IP address of your home or office router. Typical IP addresses may start with 192. or 172. or 10. The IP address on the cutter and in the computer software must be the same. Check that you are using the correct Wi-Fi password for your home router. Try moving the cutter closer to the Wi-Fi router, ideally right next to the router. I cannot get USB to connect. Note that USB is not needed if you are using Wi-Fi. Test the USB port on the computer with a different USB device. Make sure the connection settings on your computer show USB in the software. With the computer on and the software program running, remove and reinsert the USB cable to reinitialize the port. The camera does not see the registration marks when contour cutting. The camera may need calibration. Please see the previous video for this procedure. Turning the camera light on or off may help the contrast at the edge of the mark. Turning the room lights off or moving the cutter to a less bright area may also help. Make sure the registration marks have printed solidly with no missing ink areas. Make sure your printer is set to print at actual size or it will not work. Make sure that the printed artwork file matches the contour cutting file. Ensure that the printed design is placed in the cutter as straight as possible. Position the blade over the lower right registration mark just outside the mark. My cuts show tearing. Check to see that your blade is not exposed more than one half the thickness of a credit card. Try reducing the downforce. Too much force can impede material movement. Your blade may be chipped or dull and may need to be replaced. The corners of my cuts are not cutting completely. Check to see that you have the correct overcut setting in your software. A typical overcut setting is 1 millimeter, but may be more or less for different blades. When using the pen, etching tool, or engraving tool, the overcut will be zero. Make sure you have the correct blade or tool selected.